Hey guys, I'm Annika Michelle here with the wonderful Bob Saget.
Thank you for saying my name right.
Yeah, do people mispronounce it all the time?
No.
Oh, okay.
They used to. Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Thanks.
So Bob, tell us what you've been up to lately. Tell everyone like where they can catch you, what projects you've been working on.
Well, right now I'm here for John Stamos, my dear friend, for Project Cuddle, which is a wonderful organization that I've been lucky enough to be part of over the years, and it helps little kids find homes. It's a wonderful, wonderful, I'm very proud to be here, help the kids.
Help the charity.
Right,
such a
right.
Charity.
It's a great thing. And John found it because Debbie, who runs this thing, is such a go-getter. She really single-handedly did this. See, John even surprised her and had her on Oprah.
I know, I saw that. That was amazing. They surprised her on Oprah. Like, Oprah's huge. Are you kidding me?
Oprah's huge.
So, are you working on any TV shows, any movies?
I just did a new television special that's kind of not meant for little kids like there are here. And that'll be on in a few months on a major network and a cable network. And I'm writing a book for HarperCollins for It Books that'll be out at the beginning of next year, which is what I do. When I leave here, I will go home and write a book.
That's amazing. That's so good for you. And I heard rumors a couple years ago, I don't know if this is still true, that you were trying to produce a Full House movie.
Not me. John Stamos had the rights for that like long time ago. I don't think anyone has them right now. I mean, Warner Brothers probably has them.
I know that you playing Danny Tanner for so many years on Full House.
Right.
I grew up with that show. I love that show.
Right.
I'm sure you get that all the time. But do you think you playing a dad on that show has anything to do with you like having a heartfelt connection to a charity that helps kids?
Well, I am a father, and I love children. So, and it's a no-brainer, you know, helping this. And I have a lot of causes that I care about. I'm on the board of the Scleroderma Research Foundation. I lost a sister to that and the disease. And there's a lot of things I care about. But when kids are in the forefront, it's no thought involved. You just do whatever you can. And it's an honor to be asked to do anything.
Yeah. And if you guys haven't checked it out, you should watch the video with him and John Stamos, the cuddling video.
Right. That was done post-haste. Yeah, see, John wanted to get in bed with me really bad, and we said, let's do it for a cause. And I wore all black, and I just didn't want him near me. And his breath smelled like Greek yogurt that day. So. He is. He certainly is.
Hey, guys, I'm with the very sexy John Stamos.
And the very sexy.
Bob Saget, and this is a message from Maria. Hi, Maria, we miss you.
Hi, Maria. Where's Maria? Why didn't she?
I know. That's
hi, Sean. It's your other favorite Greek in the whole world. Just want to say hi. I miss you. I love you. Be good to my girl.
Your message, Maria.
And I'll see you soon. Let's do dinner. Opa.
Bye, Maria.
She got,
here
I'm jealous Maria got the kiss from John.
Well, you got a kiss
I
on
did.
Stage.
I got a kiss on stage at the Beach Boys concert. It was my birthday. My friends ditched me because it's Labor Day weekend, and they all went out of town, and I went to the Beach Boys concert because who better to see than John Stamos on my birthday? And he pulled me up on stage, and I got 3 birthday kisses on stage at the Beach Boys concert from the sexiest man, in my opinion.
Wow.
Did you have to take antibiotics after that?
No. I was.
That
is me.
Wow.
2 years ago, my birthday.
Stamos, a birthday kiss is my only wish.
It was very true.
I had something like that. It said, if you'll be my Saget, then I'll be your... And it was something like that.
You
I can't remember.
Stop at Saget.
It's for a kid thing.
So, John, can you tell us why you wanted to get involved with Project Cuddle?
Well, you know, Debbie was a friend of the family, and my sister originally asked me to get involved because she was trying to help her friends adopt a baby, and they were having problems. So my sister basically said, like, if you help my friends get a baby to Debbie, then my sister said, well, I'll deliver Stamos, my brother, to one of your. Basically, my sister was whoring me out, pimping
much.
Me out. Yeah,
like
but
sister, what,
right,
someone sexy like you.
So I did some research, and I was like, "Wow, this is an incredible, organization," and I felt I could really help out. And it's been fantastic. It's been 8 years, and you know what we do. I mean, you sort of get it. And then
how's the interview going?
She's better
direct,
than me. Yeah,
much
she's
better
good.
Than me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you explained about Project Cuddle and Debbie.
We did, yes. So it was one of those great totally tangible charities that I thought, well, if I got a little involved, I could really help because we're saving babies, it's so easy. And then my dear friend, Bob, who is my best friend, and he showed up for me today and
like
always
sisters.
Does. we're like sisters, but we don't.
You can stop rubbing me now.
Oh, okay.
They're getting really close back here.
Well, he rubs me and he gets his wishes if he does it three times.
You're hilarious. Well, it's so great. Thank you so much for stopping by. I know you're busy. Everyone's trying to grab you and pull you away from me. But thank you. Thank you to Maria, too. And this is great. Thank you so much.
Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you, too.
Thanks for having us, Maria.
Thank you.